Thanks. So, well, Glenn, as you might know, I went to Nashville to become a country music star. And I'll tell you just that, when I got on the bus, and I got to Nashville, I had my guitar and a couple bags, you know, and that's my thing. Well, I checked into the motel, and the first thing I did, I dropped off my bags, I got my guitar, went down to the liquor store, got me a Mad Dog 2020 and a box of non-filter Camels, and I went bar hopping. And it was great. I was doing open mic things in between bands and whatnot. It was received quite well. And we had about the third bar, I'm halfway through a tune, man, I'm just going away, it's burning, you know, and all of a sudden this gigantic white woman comes jacking me off the stage, man, by the scruff of the neck. I'm like, well, he said, boy, you're gonna have to help me to the toilet. I said, man, I said, boy, you're gonna have to help me to the toilet, because I'm too fucked up doing myself, I don't want to make a mess. And I was a little scared, and I helped her, and I gently helped her upon the throne. And I got the fuck out, you know, I grabbed my guitar, and I went back to the motel, I walked through the door, all my shit stole. I said, fuck Nashville, man, it's too weird for me. I'm going back home to Shreveport. You know, I wasn't home more than 20 minutes, and hell, I was in jail, man. Cause in one pocket I had a quarter pound of weed, and the other one I had a quarter of moonshine, and here I'm in jail. My bail was like $1,800 or whatnot. And I called my cousin, and I was like, boy, I'm in jail, you gotta help me out. And he bailed me out, and I had to pay him, and I had to do some sheet metal work for about 2 months, and paid him back, and boy, it sucked. I said, fuck Shreveport, man. Let's go back to New Orleans. And I've been there about 2 days. And the first night I get back, I was staying with my boy, you know, and his girlfriend's rubbing on me, wanting to sex me up. And I'm like, honey, I'm just into big black women. I don't like skinny white girls. And this really pissed her off. And she left. And next morning, she comes along and she's rapping on the door about 6 a.m. I open it up. She had this big, gigantic stuffed frog. And I'm like, honey, she said, Jimmy, this is for you. I'm like, well, honey, I appreciate the sentiment, but what the fuck I'm gonna do with a big gigantic frog, you know? And this really upset her, and she said, you don't like it? I said, well, she said, fine then. She set it on fire and threw it on the ground. Well, me and my roommates just jumping on and whatnot, and went back to the high hole, started drinking, been drunk ever since. Clint, what you been up to lately? Thank y'all, man. If y'all can hear the lyrics, man, I'm trying to do something poetic. I'm trying to do something different. I wanted to, fuck it, man. Tom Waits is my daddy, Charles Mingus is my granddaddy. We'll just go with that. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah! everybody, love your Liquidrone. Peace out.